Hi everyone, it's Tiffany. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be unboxing the Disney Mickey and the Beanstalk game based off of Mickey and the Beanstalk. I don't know if you are aware of that actual story. If you could watch it in Fun and Fancy Free or you could read the book. It is one of my favorites. I love it. Great music too. This game is for ages 4 and up, 2 to 4 players. It has a beautiful work on the sides of the actual box, all over the box. The artwork is just amazing. It's going to look so good on your toys and game shelf. It's going to look amazing, especially if the spine is sticking out and showing off to the world. The object of the game is to spin the spinner and sneak across the giant's table without disturbing him, and he is supposed to bring the food back down the beanstalk safely. And the characters really spin down that vine, so it really gives a really fun effect. Again, this is 2 to 4 players. Let's get it unboxed. I'm gonna show you how to play. Oh my gosh, let's just gush over this package. Even the outer portion of the inner carton, because it's a two-piece box. Look at this artwork on the side. It's all four sides. Like, how gorgeous is this? Then we have the inside of the box. It shows everything that you get. You're gonna set up the game inside of the carton. No wonder we have all that beautiful artwork, because we're gonna keep everything contained in the actual box of the game. Okay, now that I got this whole game board set up, it's really, really simple to follow. Just be very, very careful. This is the first Funko games that I've encountered during this whole unboxing experience of unboxing all the Disney Funko games, where it started to separate a little bit from the gray board. So just be careful when you're piecing everything all together. Full instructions to set up the game board are on the back of the instructions. Super, super easy to follow. Next, you're gonna separate the food tokens by shape, and you're gonna keep the plates facing down. You should not see the white part that actually shows like the ingredients. Keep it plate facing down. Here is the lockbox mat. You're gonna place the golden harp on one of the 8 boxes. Now, these courage tokens you're gonna set aside for your first. Then each player chooses their character, either Mickey, Goofy, Donald, or Minnie Mouse. Then each player takes their respective card mat and puts it in front of them. The youngest player is gonna spin and go first. Now, basically the object of the game is to get all of Happy Valley fed. So each of the houses have 3 areas that you have to fill. Now, it's sort of like a cooperative game where all of the players help each other. So let's say you go up to the giant and you visit him and you collect food. Let's say this is Goofy's house and he doesn't have potatoes, but he has carrots. He can collect carrots and give it to Donald's house. So everybody can help out each other. This question mark is for any type of food that you want. So this has potato, cheese, and you could put a tomato in that one. If you happen to land on a key on the table, then you can collect a key space. And this key is going to help you unlock that lockbox when you go in front of the giant. Now, the giant's not always gonna stay there, but I'll get to that. You're gonna use that key to unlock the lockbox to collect your golden harp. Now, sometimes this lockbox is gonna be full with other food that the giant has taken. If the giant fills up the entire lockbox, the game is over and everybody loses. So the object of the game is to try and get that golden harp before the giant fills up the lockbox. Now, every time you spin, you're going to, the one player is going to spin, the first one, the youngest one, and you see that it says 3 and it's a green spot right here. You're gonna move the giant over here. And then let's say it's Goofy's turn. He's gonna use 1 space, that's 1. Then go to a drawbridge, that's 2. And since he spun 3, he goes to 3. Now, since Goofy has landed on the square plate, he can grab a square food token and then add that to his player card. He got potatoes, and it's perfect. He needs potatoes for his town too. Then the next player is going to spin. Okay, so now it is purple 4. Oh boy, so where is purple 4? Oh no! Okay, good, let's put him over here. Now he has a food. It's okay, he's not going to take one food because he's moved to the closest color and there's nobody in front of him, so he's not taking anything. So now it is Donald's turn. So Donald spun 4. So he's gonna go 1, Drawbridge is 2, and then he can hop up and jump, and he can stay there. He can go hop up. So this is 1, 2, hop up, 3, and then 4. Now he can get a lockbox key. This is awesome because we need this to try and get to the lockbox and save the golden harp. Now you go to Donald's character card and add that key. Now we all have to get Donald to the lockbox. So let's just collect food. So let's hopefully get food. Some meat. Mickey's turn. Let's see what we got. Okay, it's green 3. Very, very, very good. So now we're gonna go over here. Please. Now it is back Goofy's turn. So Goofy, we landed on a food token. So now, since we landed on the food portion of the spin, now the giant is gonna take a food token and put it in the lockbox. Forth with this giant, and now it is Donald's time to shine. Let's say he just happens to spin a 4, we can get the giant over here in the purple area, and then you don't have to go and move 4 spaces. You can move the number of spaces that you need up to 4. So he needs to just move 1. So now we can take that golden key and we can put it over here and exchange it for the golden harp. Now it is Donald's mission to get back down, and everybody can submit all of the fruits and vegetables that they have collected down the beanstalk. Able to bring all of the food that they got from their journey up the beanstalk. Now that all of the spaces are full of the food, the game is over and Happy Valley is now safe and totally fed. If you want to continue gameplay after you play the first one, you can put these courage tokens into play. So basically these courage tokens are gonna help prevent the giant from putting anything inside of that lockbox. So anytime he's gonna lock something away, you can step in with the courage tokens that you have collected and exchange it. And this could be on any turn, but you cannot be in Happy Valley when it happens. You have to be up the beanstalk. I hope this was really, really informative. I watched Funko Games video. I read the instructions. I was having a little bit of confusion, but I was able to figure it out after I put 2 and 2 together. It's pretty easy. There's a lot of thought involved, which is very, very typical with Funko Games. I actually love it. I think the artwork is beautiful. I think the idea is fun. And I just think this is a really, really neat game board. I've never seen anything like this where they slide down. It kind of has like that mousetrap vibe, but it's really, really cool and interactive. It's something for like older kids, definitely like for a fun game night. Super cool. And if you're a fan of Fun and Fancy Free and Mickey and the Beanstalk, then you should totally get this game. It's super cool. It looks really, really good on the shelf. The giant's awesome. I love the giant. He's one of my favorite characters. And I just think this is a really, really cool game. And it's going to be easy to put back together too.